your Masters Theatre in London, and I'm here for Adrian Mole the musical. So it's based on a book by Sue Townsend, and it's now a musical. So apparently it was at the Chocolate Factory, not Willy Wonka's, the other one, and then it was at the Cave, and now it's here in London's West End for the summer. So I don't know much about this show, and I've never read the books. I'm not very good at reading, I'm dyslexic. And I'm excited to see what's coming up, because I saw a bit of it at West End Live, and it blew me away. I'm just a bit misunderstood. I'm just a bit misunderstood. Cause when you're 40, I'm pubescent. Teenage adolescent, lost in child. It's just the interval now, and it's a bloody brilliant, honestly. It's great to see new British musicals on the West End. It's absolutely fantastic. So Adrian Mole, it's very, very funny. I didn't know it was going to actually be this funny, and I've not stopped laughing. Some of the jokes, you know, do go over the kids' heads, which is exciting, because then the adults can enjoy it. Because you know what? Some shows are too kiddy, and this one is, you know, it caters for all. It caters for the boys, the girls, the dads, the mums, the aunties, the uncles, the nans, the grandads, and all the in-between. So it's really funny. The music's very catchy. They've just released a cast recording, and I shall be getting it. Will you, Jordan?
Yes!
I mean, not the disc, because I'm a streaming girl.
I'm an Apple Music girl.
And me.
I like a cassette tape.
I don't think it'll go with the audience, because a lot of kids don't know what a cassette tape is.
I just heard a really funny thing in the toilet when they were reading the back of the toilets, and they went, "Mum, it says the story of Adrian Mole, Jerry Adrian Mole during the 2020 minutes. Is this what we're watching now?"
Right, if they're not getting it, it's called Adrian Mole, when there's a sign at the start saying Adrian Mole.
I'm really worried about that child.
That child shouldn't be allowed in the theatre.
My favourite thing.
Are you enjoying it?
I'm having a great
it's
time.
It's very good. A lot of good energy.
I think it's got lots of good energy. It's just good fun, isn't it?
Very funny. The guy next to me is having a ball. He is absolutely weighing himself. Honestly, he's laughing more than anyone, and I love that.
I love the fact that it's all like adults playing kids and vice versa.
That's funny. I didn't know that was going to happen, but no, the kids love that. Like, it's very, like, you know, CBBC humour, and I think that they've got that hit the nail on the head.
Hashtag BBC poetry competition.
Yeah. That BBC line was hysterical. Don't know what it was, but it was funny. Do you remember it? It's really funny. Now, if you're watching this and you've got kids, or you are a child and your parents love you, get them to take you to Adrian Mole, because this is going to be a summer banger. I mean, it's here till, you know, the end of the year. But I think summer holidays, 6 weeks off, who needs to get to Barmouth? Who needs to get to Devon? Go and see Adrian Mole, because it's very funny. The music is fabulous. It's high energy. It's very glitz and glamour. A lot of good lighting. I love the lighting. Very good. And the kids are fantastic, honestly. When I was a child, I could just about walk, let alone dance. And I couldn't speak because I had a stutter, so for them to sing is very impressive. And I'm blown away, I really am. And I'm looking forward to Act 2. So I'll let you know how we're getting on. But at the minute, loving it. Go Adrian, go Mole. Mole, Mole, Mole. So I've dressed up for the occasion, Adrian Mole, because it's like a little bit of a schoolboy thing. I've worn my badges. I was a play leader at school, so I led all the play. So all the funs and games, I led those, and if you weren't my friend, you weren't allowed to play with me. So I've also got my school council one, because I was a counsellor. And Adrian Mole, I would have let him on my council, because he's a very smart fellow, very funny boy. And also, Pandora, she's a very smart lady. She really is. And she could be the Prime Minister, doing a better job than Theresa May. Doing that bloody more, she'd get us through Brexit. Bloody nightmare, that is. There's also some really sweet moments in the show. It's quite heartfelt. I didn't realise it'd be quite emotional in bits, you know, because it's about broken family and things like that. And it's very emotional, and I got the goosebumps and I cried at some bits. It was beautiful. It was really good. I'm going to get down to the Ambassador's to see it again, because you know what? Phenomenal production. Really good. I just want to big up the writers of the music. and the lyrics. Absolutely fantastic. It's nice to hear a new score, you know. Really catchy music. I am going to listen to the soundtrack on repeat because we're a little bit misunderstood, and that's one of the songs from it that's really catchy and stuck in my head. The characters, absolutely fantastic. Honestly, I've laughed so hard. There were some bits, it's a bit like Panto, you know. You've got the naughty jokes that just go over the kid's head. And it's hilarious, honestly. Everyone was laughing. It was absolutely phenomenal. And if you're down London, get down to it, because it's hilarious. And you know what? We need to support British theatre, because people don't give some shows a chance unless they know it.
Crowd up on their feet. They absolutely loved it. I've never laughed so much at a show in my life. It was so funny. The characters were hilarious, brilliant. And the crowd are going wild in here. Fabulous show. Make sure you go and see it.